everybody. Glad you've made the decision to be with us. Alongside Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. We're glad to be bringing you action and welcoming you to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada for our main event. 10 rounds of heavyweight action. This should be a good one tonight. Both fighters say they are prime, coming off a very intense and passionate training camp. The Brown Bomber's making his way to the ring now, and he looks very focused for this fight. Dollar Bill showing no concern for what's about to happen. This is a guy that is just relaxed and calm as could be for the task at hand as he makes his way down to the ring.
Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, the Brown Bomber, Wilder. His adversary, fighting out of the red corner, Dorn Bill.
All right, gentlemen. Protect yourselves at all times. Let's touch him up.
Scheduled to go the full 10 if we get that far. Round one underway. What a destructive hook to the head by the Brown Bomber. Very nice work there. Jab, uppercut. Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Up top with the right hand. Wow, no doubt about it, affected by that right hand. If I were him, I'd be hanging on a little bit here.
Two guys that can really take each other out. What's the best means of defense?
Well, if one guy says to himself, I'm not the power puncher, then he has to be smart. He has to be technically solid in all areas. He's gonna have the edge.
Dollar Bill's nailed by a hook. Takes one to give one. He comes back with a right hand. Took a shot. Now he gives a left. Lands a big hook. Oh, that's good stuff. Fired right back with one of his own. Good work by Dollar Bill. And now he's targeting upstairs. Dollar Bill's done a good job there offensively scoring with that left hand. A headshot blocked. Nice strike after catching one by Dollar Bill. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Final 10 seconds of round number one. The Brown Bomber's not just loading up. He's landing combination punches like he did right there. And that's the end of round one. Dollar Bill's getting hit too much. I mean, it's as simple as that, Teddy. He comes back after that round, and he just got popped a lot.
Yeah, well, right now, he's got to find a way to get away from some of those punches, but there's a problem, a big problem, like with anything else.
Big left hand. Solid right by Dollar Bill. Now he's targeting upstairs. The Brown Bomber's so dangerous with that accuracy, a two-punch combination landing. And now he scores well. What a big shot. Oh, he doesn't look good. He just went down, and not the way he wanted it to go.
Now he's standing on the outside, Joe. He shouldn't be standing there. The old-timers would say, take a walk around the block.
One, two.
Hard to prepare for a situation like this, but many do. He's been down, now he's got to survive.
So that's where you're wrong. It's not hard to prepare, it's a must to prepare. if you're a trainer, that's what you do in the gym. You teach a guy, if you're in this situation, this is what you do. You grab on, you move your head, you survive.
Halfway through this round here. Able to land the hook to the head. Great hook to the head that time. That's classic work with the double jab. A huge uppercut by the Brown Bomber. He fires off the combination there and it lands.
Keep working it, Jeff. There you go.
Way to block there. Here's one for you now, he says. Right back with the left hand. The Brown Bomber's jab can do so much there. He used it well that time. Comes right back at him with a left hand. Thought he had his target, but way off to the side with the uppercut. And that's the end of round two.
Don't walk.
The Brown Bomber's grasp of real estate is something special. Look how he just stays on the outside early on in this fight and is able to find his target.
Well, you're right, Joe. It's prime real estate for him. I mean, he's in a neighborhood he wants to be on the outside.
A well-targeted jab that time.
And that's exactly what you need when you want to stay on the outside. Something to keep you away from your opponent.
The Brown Bomber's coming out to fight this round after being knocked down in the previous round. Teddy, any idea? Do you think he's recouped enough here?
Well, we're going to find out very quickly by looking at his legs. You're going to look downstairs just like you look downstairs in the basement of a house to see whether or not those bricks are in place or whether or not some of the mortar has kind of disappeared and the bricks are a little loose. You want to see if those legs are stable, if they're firm.
Jab with a straight, classic combination. Very accurate with the overhand right. The Brown Bomber's punch didn't come close. Scored well upstairs with the right hand. Not hitting his mark there going upstairs. Here's a moment here as you see the step back counterpunch where you realize this is the sweet science, not just some raw savagery swinging out there.
Look at the little subtleties here, Joe. What he does is he forces him into a position to stop the punch. And then when he stops, steps back, makes a miss, and comes right back.
The Brown Bomber's combination punching is just perfect there. Three punches landing. Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by the Brown Bomber. And that's the end of round three.
Bang away, okay?
Well, with three rounds complete here, it's worth a look at Teddy's scorecard to see where he sees it. Well, I don't know if he's hip to the idea of becoming a counterpuncher, but I get the sense you'd agree with it.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he's got the perfect platform, the perfect form for it. The guy's walking in right now, not moving his head much.
Big shot there. How about that? He goes from being the victim to handing out the punishment. So he is able to get up to his feet after that knockdown. But Teddy, it's what's ahead that's the problem.
Yeah, we're getting a peek right now into his heart, into his soul.
And now we got a fight. He fires back a right hand of his own. See, not just one jab. He throws that second one right behind it. Brown Bomber's showing you that sublime skill right now with that two-punch combo. He had his eyes set on the uppercut, but was unable to land it.
Keep it tight inside.
Bill's left working well that time. There's that southpaw jab in the left hand. The Brown Bombers making for a clinic here in combination punching.
Well, the first couple punches here, Joe, they're throwaway punches to really set up the payoff down the road. You see the third punch, the fourth punch, the fifth punch. They are the ones that wind up landing.
Very good, steady double jab there. The Brown Bomber swinging and missing like he's at bat right there. That punch was nowhere near his opponent. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. The round comes to an end. And for one fighter here, the fight may come to an end, Teddy, if something doesn't change real quick. I mean, you can just look at him and see that he's in rough shape.
Well, look, sometimes it's your responsibility as a cornerman, as a trainer, to come up with some advice technically on how to change things. Sometimes it's about stopping a fight. Maybe the best thing right now is that corner has to start thinking about maybe enough is enough.
Nice work, the left hand to the head.
You're not focusing.
That's great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by the Brown Bomber. Dollar Bills is seasoned pro, and old pros tend to fall into the same pattern. Nothing has changed with him stylistically since he's been knocked down in this fight.
Well, that falls right into that pattern or that cliche where old dogs can't be taught new tricks. Well, right now, he's going to have to come up with a trick or two, maybe, to survive this moment.
How about a return to sender with the left hand? Dollar Bill's inconsistencies are really showing up now. At times, he has shown defense tonight. Other times, with what we've seen recently, he's getting hit by the left hand.
Yeah, what he had to do is now make the adjustment.
Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark. The Brown Bomber's able to land a nice, clean left hand. He scores with the jab there. He's got confidence he can track, and he just did there.
And he had the distance, Joe, the height that he wanted to set up that punch.
The Brown Bomber's just punching air that time. His opponent was able to get out of the way. And that's the end of round five. How about this? Round after round, and much the same. Just brilliant fighting from the outside. Now there's the jab. Good clean shot, returning fire. Well done by Dollar Bill.
You're still not moving enough. Move.
The Brown Bomber's combination punching is working well here. And now just wasting away some time with that clinch. The Brown Bomber's just being smart on the outside. And he just holds on there. The Brown Bomber's landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. Fine looking right hand by Dollar Bill. Dollar Bill's showing a little bit of a defensive shell, but Teddy, I'm seeing punches still getting through and splitting that guard.
Yeah, well, that's the problem, Joe, when you put those earmuffs on, but you don't move your head. Some of them are going to get through, and just as importantly, you handcuff yourself, so your opponent is going to stay in there a little bit longer, knowing that nothing's coming back right away.
The Brown Bomber's getting himself into the mix now, landing that left hand. This round comes to an end. We've seen this all night long. Headshots coming in against him. Dollar Bill's defense is just not up to speed here.
Now, Joe, and it hasn't been, as you just said, all night long. It's getting late in the game now, and I think it's getting to the point where the referee has to start looking at the possibility, and even a corner, of stopping this fight.
Right to the head with that right. Targeting upstairs.
Nice.
The Brown Bombers putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination. And now just wasting everybody's time holding on.
Headbutt.
Oh, and he's got something for him himself, and it's a left hand. The Brown Bomber's favorite punch is the jab, and tonight, he's loving it.
Well, the jab is the table setter, Joe, and he set a beautiful table tonight. Napkin on the left, you know, small fork on the left, knife on the right, and the food right in the middle. And he's eating all night.
You taking some English etiquette classes?
You getting hungry?
Well, what do they say, Teddy? Something's got to stick. That combination was something.
Well, you know what it was? The first couple punches were throwaway punches. Set up the later punches.
The Brown Bomber's right hand did a nice job that time. That worked well for him. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. And we come to the end of the round.
I need you.
The Brown Bomber's been making a point of working harder. He's the busier fighter, throwing more punches. And as we start round number 8, he's up big on Teddy's scorecard.
Well, he's getting little opposition. I mean, the other guy must have a big bank account or something. You know what the other guy's corner should do?
What?
They should tell him that.
Wow! That combination puts him down. But he's going to continue on, beating the count. Takes one, but gets one. Good work by the Brown Bomber. Well off the mark by Dollar Bill. They trade shots. He comes back with a right hand. There's the headshot, but he parries it away. The Brown Bomber's doing well here with it. Dollar Bill's in a tough spot right now. Look at that. He goes down thanks to a swarming attack. He got caught up in a mixer blade there. Dollar Bill's able to survive that knockdown, but Teddy, is it only a matter of time at this point?
It's up to what he does right now as soon as the referee lets him.
Big shot. Wow, he goes down again.
This is going to be more the elevator fight. Up and down all night.
Over. The Brown Bomber's corner is already celebrating. His opponent unable to beat the count. Now that's how you end a fight right there. Yes, he was controlling throughout, but he made a good, clean finish with the knockout.
Yeah, as a trainer, you want to know, can a guy punch? Can a guy defend? You know, can a guy control distance? But you want to know, can a guy...